It's the most fun I've had on a movie set in years. Really, just good, easy fun. It's everybody in the family except Marissa's character having a sing along with your classic songs, a nice little spin. Alan is an incredible ukulele player, and Ed is a very talented guitar player and pianist. Got Alex Borstein is playing the cello, which she learned a year ago, and she's really good at it. John Goodman, he's got so much soul. We share a trailer, so I can hear through the walls. He's always listening to good jazz music, and he has it flowing in his blood. So he's really rocking it out on the harmonica. Everybody's singing. It's a good time. People are putting their own spin on the traditional Christmas songs, and it's I think it's gonna be T-Bone Burnett's doing our music, so we had him come out last night for a couple hours. It's so much more than I expected. There are characters in the movie who aren't really related, like Alex's character is not related, but she's only related through marriage, and Jake, Lacy, and I are strangers, and we're brought into this family. Last week on set, sitting around for 10 hours straight with nothing to do in a chapel in a hospital has also helped create a nice bond energy between us all. Ruby is she's a waitress, and she's had a really tough upbringing. You see that in the movie. Everybody's got a good, clear flashback, so the audience kind of understands where they're coming from. And she doesn't really have much of a family. She's brothers, but she wants to get out of here. She's not super happy, and she's just kind of fed up with her life at the moment, and she makes few connections, and one of the connections she makes is with Bucky, who comes to the diner, this diner she works at every day, sometimes twice a day for 3 years. They've been really hitting it off, and they kind of fall in love in a way. It transcends age and experience. It's more of just about these two souls that are a little bit lost, and it's amazing to see it, to feel it happening. I have a very similar connection to Alan in real life, and so I'm like, it's always a reason. And there's always a reason, you know, there was a reason I feel like Ruby was where she was in her life to meet Bucky, and I feel the same way about me. But yeah, that's basically what she is. That's who Ruby is. It's a gray area, like most families. I think they all have their own stuff that they're figuring out. They all have their own, they're all going through a little bit of an existential crisis and a personal crisis, and at the same time, which makes it really difficult to communicate with each other, I'm sure. But that's, when there's unconditional love there, it's like you realize at the end of the day, you know, these people, like, they know what they have. They feel lucky. I think she feels wanted and loved for the first time without doing anything she doesn't feel like she deserves it, but it's being given to her almost immediately. And I think there was a reason besides her brothers growing up that she stayed in this town at that diner working too many hours and you know, feeling like she wasn't gaining anything from it. There was a reason. Jessie's part of us. We're a part of her. It's kind of like a miracle. She, all her heart and soul is into this. She's like a mom, a good mom. And we all want to be here. So it's a good equal, there's a great balance on set, a really great balance.